The importance of branding weights. This is not going to be your typical video where I tell you how it is important to build a brand on Amazon. I really want to help you guys increase your sales in anything that you sell on Amazon. And let me tell you this very important fact that no one talks about. Let's go. Hi guys, my name is Karina. I am an Amazon FBA seller and welcome back to my channel. I really wanted to talk to you guys about the importance of a brand within Amazon. And I'm not going to be talking about the typical way and reason to why you should build a brand on Amazon. Everybody has probably heard this reiterated 50 billion times that building a brand on Amazon is the way to go. And yes, we all know that for several reasons. However, I wanted to point out another reason that I don't often hear pointed out to why it is actually important to have products in a similar niche and how it will make your life so much easier going down the road. First off, if you're a new time seller or a long-term seller and you find products that have great numbers, of course launch them. I am not against launching unbranded products. If the numbers are there, if you can add value to the market, if you can improve on it, and if you know that it will be successful, then go for it. And there are several reasons why I like to go this route. One of the number one reasons is that your product really stands out, since a lot of people, a lot of private label sellers, don't really know how to brand or make something look appealing. So when you look at all the listings, one stands out, right? I am a huge fan of bundling products and just differentiating and really stressing the importance of having a really nice looking package, because I think that is the number one attractor in Amazon. It's the photos that a person sees. A customer sees an amazing photo, they're going to be drawn towards it and they're gonna click it and buy it, especially if you have something else for a similar or slightly higher price point than your whole competition. This already gives you credibility, plus at the thing that everyone loves, you can increase your price of your item. And that's why I like it, because sometimes the margin is barely there, but if you bundle it and add value, look and feel premium, then you already have that advantage and you can mark up your item a few dollars and your profit margins just increase right there, because over a long period of time, it's gonna be higher ROI and it's just perfect. That's what I personally like to do. And branding also makes it very easy for you to pick out your next product. And I know why a lot of people kind of get scared by branding or shy away from branding, because, and this is exactly how I thought when I first started Amazon, it's already difficult enough to find one product that's going to do well. How the heck are you supposed to find multiple, not only that, but ones that all fit into the same brand? So they basically have to be in the same niche, right? It's like, what are the odds that the products that you're going to be launching are all going to be great home run products all in the same category? And that's literally the fear I had. And then that's why I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna find a product to sell and hope that goes well. But this is when I was starting out. Let me tell you guys, now I am a huge advocate of brand building. I enjoy it so much more. It's more fun. So now that's what I do with all my stuff in Amazon, is I really like to have premium brands, no matter what category it's in. And I'm always looking for that next product to add. But this is what people don't tell you. The real importance of branding, and that is you have more space, you have more real estate in Amazon, right? And I don't know why people don't talk about this. So let me explain the concept to you. You find one product that has really good numbers, and then you look for similar keywords, or, you know, in the same niche of products that may be similar. A lot of the times you can find a product that has very similar keywords, and that is where you hit gold, guys. I have done this several times, and it is my absolute favorite when that happens, because you find products that could rank for the same keywords, and this allows you to do magic within Amazon. Because if you already have a large market share with one product, imagine adding supplemental products that you could rank for the same keywords and potentially take up real estate on the first page of Amazon. Now, anytime someone clicks on the first page, they see your initial product. Plus, on top of that, they might see slight variations of your product that is also showing up on page one. Not only does this give you credibility, since people are seeing your brand several times, also that prevents other sellers from taking the spot on page one. And that is a really, really cool thing. You can eliminate like potentially 2 to 3 competitors if you rank for that keyword on the first page, and that is gold. So you don't have to have all these products be home run products. Like, honestly, you really don't have to have all of them doing crazy amount of revenue. But think about it, if you add 3 to 5 products in that same category for the same words, and you're even making like, I don't know, like less than $500 of income from each single product, you're already up a couple thousand dollars extra in your pocket. Not only that, you are increasing those sales to you as opposed to other competitors, and those customers who are buying from you are not buying from your competitors, therefore they will come back and buy from you later as well. And also, when people are searching for what to buy and they see one brand pop up every now and again, it's, oh, well, this is popping up a lot, which means probably this is a credible brand and I should buy from them. It seems to be all over the place. So that is a really, really great thing. And keep in mind, guys, like, keyword research takes a long time, and getting that data with PPC takes a long time. So if you have a product and you've already got it to the first page, you've already optimized your PPC and your listing, you know what keywords work. So it is so easy to launch those products, to launch a variation of that product. You already have access to all those keywords. You can just plug them in. You're saving yourself hundreds of dollars from having to run PPC again and trying to find out by method of paying, pay to play, right? To see which keywords are going to convert for your product, because you already know, you've done this already. And the one thing also to benefit from, if you are running PPC ads, right? This is genius. I do this all the time. And you have similar products or slight variations, you can actually advertise against yourself. Amazon gives you the ability to target specific ASINs, which is basically a product. You can target whatever product you want in the field, right? If it's relevant to you. So imagine, instead of a competitor showing up on your listing, you're gonna show up. So it sounds counterintuitive, because you think that, why would I spend money to advertise against myself? But you're taking away position again from a potential competitor that will compete with your product and have the customer be redirected to them. But you're spending that, let's say, $1 or under $1 to show your other listing. So that's all that the customer sees. They either see the one option they can buy from you or the second one they can buy from you. So although you think you're losing $1, you're really gaining a sale. That is something that is super, super beneficial, and I suggest you guys try that. Amazon is all about visibility, right? They can't actually feel your product, they can't hold it, they don't know that it's so much better and all these claims you make. All they know is what they see. It is 100% visual. They see a picture, they see other items popping up. If they see a certain logo or a certain brand popping up more times than other brands, they're already gonna be thinking that, hey, maybe that's the better option, and just already eliminating people on the first page. And that is literally my favorite thing about branding. Really take that into account, guys, when you're doing your product research. I hope that this video was helpful to you guys, so keep that in mind. If you guys have any questions, always leave them in the comments, send me a DM on Instagram. I'm always, always answering you guys. And subscribe to this channel, I always post videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Have an amazing day.